The trial is underway for a jockey accused of domestic abuse. Police arrested Robby Albarado earlier this summer, the morning he was due to ride in the Kentucky Oaks. Gary Parker is live at the Hall of Justice with the new developments in the case. Hi, Gary.
Eric, good afternoon. Jury selection finished just before 11 this morning, and then the opening statements were made by both the prosecution and the defense. Now, if you remember, Albarado is charged with fourth-degree assault. Now, the prosecution, in their opening statement, said an argument stems between Albarado and his girlfriend, Carolina Martinez, over an iPhone. Martinez had taken the phone from Albarado to listen to a voicemail, heard the voice of a woman on that voicemail, and that's what started this argument. Now you're about to hear what happened next from the prosecution and the defense, which also has a similar story but paints a slightly different picture.
So with alcohol in his breath and a look in his eye that Carolina has never seen, he comes at her. He comes at her and grabs her arms, and she knows, I shouldn't let go of this phone because I don't know what else to do. He grabs her arms, then he wraps her around in a bear hug, and he takes her down and lands on top of her. She lands on her right side.
It's a small space, and you'll see pictures. The closet and the bathroom floor look like yours and mine. There's shoes, there's towels, there's stuff. And she has said multiple times to multiple people, including the police and everybody else, we fell. We fell down. I fell on my shoulder.
So again, we first heard from the prosecution arguing Albarado had taken down his girlfriend to the ground, but the defense saying that they just fell by accident, as what seems to be the situation at the moment. Now, witness testimony is expected to continue today, including testimony from Alvarado's girlfriend at the time. And of course, we'll keep you updated with all the details as they become available. Reporting live outside the Hall of Justice, I'm Gary Parker, WLKY News.